Last week, we learned about Paul and Barnabas who went on their journey to be missionaries and telling other people about Jesus. This week, we're going to learn about Paul's second missionary journey. This time, he decided to take Silas with him. They went to Lystra to encourage the believers Paul had met on his first missionary journey. Paul and Silas also told other people the good news about Jesus so they could believe on him. They were not ashamed of the gospel they were preaching. Just like what our memory verse says in Romans 1:16, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation." As Paul and Silas traveled around, more and more people believed on Jesus every day and the church grew. In Lystra, Paul met Timothy, a young man who was liked by all the believers and would be a good missionary. Timothy joined Paul and Silas on their journey. The three missionaries sailed across the sea to Philippi, the main city of Macedonia. There they taught people that Jesus died and rose again to save them from their sins. But Paul didn't preach the message inside in a church building, he preached outside. The three missionaries worshiped and prayed with the Christians at the riverside, not knowing that trouble was near. And this trouble was a slave girl who was filled with an evil spirit. The Bible says she was a fortune teller. The evil spirit gave her the ability to tell people secrets about their lives and things that would happen to them. Her owners became rich because people paid them to talk to her and, you know, wanting to know about their future and secrets. God tells us in his word that fortune telling, like witchcraft, is evil and we shouldn't have anything to do with it. You know, because we believe in God who, you know, tells us and we know and believe that he has good plans for us and, you know, knows about our future, our present, our past. But and we shouldn't put our faith or our trust in, you know, somebody else who might be fortune telling. But we put our faith in God who knows he has good things for us. So day after day, this girl followed Paul and Silas, shouting things about them. She shouted things like, "These men are servants of the Most High God who are telling you the way to be saved." Now, that is true, but Paul was disturbed because he knew that the evil spirit was speaking through her. And, you know, the evil spirit was kind of like mocking them. So finally, after many days, Paul turned and said to the evil spirit inside of the girl, "I command you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her." And immediately the evil spirit left the girl. Now, how do you think the girl's owners felt when they found out they couldn't use her to make money anymore? Probably angry. So they quickly grabbed Paul and Silas and dragged them to the marketplace to meet with the town rulers. "These men are ruining our city," they cried. "They are teaching things that are against Roman law." Now, are they telling the truth? Probably not. They were just being angry and greedy. The rulers listened to the angry men and a huge crowd of people started to gather. The rulers also became angry and shouted that Paul and Silas should be beaten. So Paul and Silas were beaten with rods, which caused painful sores on their bodies. Then they were thrown into the dark dungeon of the prison and locked up, and their feet were put in stocks. Paul and Silas sat with their backs bleeding, their feet locked, and, you know, with darkness all around them without even a candle. Now, at this point, it would be easy for Paul and Silas to be sad and hopeless, angry, afraid, because God had sent them to the city and they were witnessing for him, and yet they were being treated cruelly and, you know, thrown into this situation. But did Paul and Silas complain and grumble? No. They trusted and they knew that God the Holy Spirit was with them right there and helping them. Sometimes we might be in a tough situation or, you know, we're living in hard times. And in that time, if you know and believe on Jesus to be your Savior, know that God the Holy Spirit is with you and will help you even in hard times. Say it with me, God's power is amazing. So even when there's tough things that are happening around you, don't put your faith into those things, but put your trust in God who will help you and will be with you because God is amazing. Now, to find out the rest of this story, go to the Hope Church website to watch part 2 of the sermon message and check out all the other resources.